Teachers of Reddit, what is the worst case of helicopter parenting you have ever encountered? My mom tried to be the helicopter parent. She wasn't great at that, but tried. It was bad enough it crippled me in junior high and high school. There were many things I didn't know how to do because I was more afraid to do it on my own without being dependent. I quickly grew out of it sophomore junior year. Thank God. But let's see. I didn't know how to get a summer job. I was too afraid to do extracurricular activities. I was extremely shy for a while there. A lot of school functions and simple classwork I didn't do because doing it on my own was difficult. Though she never did it for me. More, she told me to do it but tried to do everything else for me. She got me a girlfriend. That was awkward when I learned she was my girlfriend in truth or dare. Blah blah blah. My brother won't do anything for himself because she tries to do it for him and buys him what he wants. She got me a girlfriend. That was awkward when I learned she was my girlfriend in truth or dare. Okay, we need some backstory on this. A guy who works for me is 28 years old. He recently got a serious DUI. He blew 0.27 after rear-ending someone. He has to keep me in the loop on his court dates, etc. Whenever I ask him what is going on with his case, he has to call his father who fills him in on the details. His father has handled everything for him from hiring the lawyer, to setting up hearings and alcohol counseling. He sends him calendar appointments when to show up and where. Also, his father just bought him a car and a house, and his mother brings his lunch to work some days. I mean, if my dad's in the area he'll bring me lunch and we'll eat together, but my parents would frick my butt with a cheese grater if I got a DUI. Not a teacher, but I had an old classmate whose mother used to come to the school every lunchtime to personally feed her kid, along with his nanny. I saw her spoon feeding him sometimes and she would always make him brush his teeth in the school toilets afterward. She would come into the toilets with him. This was in 4th grade. No big surprise, this kid is a big fat freak. This was in 4th grade. I had more fun imagining this to be a high school student. At a middle school I taught at, we had 3 teen mothers come in and talk to 6th graders about the importance of using birth control. The dad of one student insisted that he sit in on the class, came in wearing a Jesus t-shirt, and in front of all the students and teachers in the classroom asked the teen moms, would you describe yourselves as moral people? Do you go to church? His question basically sucked the oxygen out of the room and everyone was incredibly uncomfortable. The other teacher was another younger guy like me and we talked at recess duty about how we wanted to punch the dad in the face and throw him out. What in butthole? Right? Because kids who go to church never have teenage sex. For my daughter's first day of school and preschool, she actually started in April the year before. My wife took 3 days off work. Her intentions were to pull up a chair next to our daughter and make sure she paid attention, etc. After 5 minutes, the teacher realized my wife wasn't leaving, so she called the principal and had her tossed. So glad I was working, although I would have loved to witness that, as I tell my wife all the time she helicopter parents. I would often get parents coming in to say I was picking on her son-daughter. Basically, it amounted to her kid consistently disrupted class and rarely ever put forth effort. Every time I tried to discipline the student, they would complain. With one daughter parent, it eventually became clear she was bothered because every time her daughter got in trouble or failed a project quiz test, I was calling her at work and thus bugging her. It wasn't an issue that her daughter was failing or preventing her peers from learning. It was that I was consistently informing her, "You're bugging me at work," I often heard. "Well, your kid is bugging me at work." My ex-wife, 40, living at home since our divorce 5 years ago, had her daddy call my father to ask if he could convince me not to take child support from her. I was just laid off from my 50k a year job, where she was taking child support from me for 4 years. She makes 65k and again lives at home with Ma and Pa. When my mom taught kindergarten, she had a student who was 4 years old for most of the year. Your kid really should be 5 entering kindergarten. I don't care how smart you think they are. The developmental gap between 4 and 5 year olds is huge and it's really unfair to other students for teachers to have to put all their energy into one student. And he was still struggling and pretty disruptive by the end of the year. She recommended keeping him in kindergarten for 1 more year. But they lost it at her and said that didn't fit in with the plan, and that if their kid was going to be an NFL quarterback, he couldn't be in school in his prime drafting years or something like that. Then they told her she just didn't know how to teach black kids and enrolled him in first grade. He's in sixth now and still struggles big time. I'll never understand the helicopter parent mentality. I was never more proud of my 13-year-old son when he told me he had done the barefoot test on a towel ship, up one side of the rigging, across the yard and down the other side in his bare feet, while under sail. My wife was a bit nervous, but when she saw him she recognized that his confidence had gone up quite a bit. I have a kid that knows his limitations and is quietly confident in his abilities. I have no clue why someone would coddle their kid to the point of uselessness. Fear. They are too scared of what might happen to let their kid go. I teach a college freshman business calculus course. In order to advance to being a real business major, you have to pass this class during your first year. The same goes for biology. The class is not difficult. There are resources upon resources that can help you in this class if you struggle. Honestly, if you can't pass this, then you shouldn't be in charge of anyone's money. It's really just advanced algebra with a few derivatives thrown in at the end of the semester. Without fail, I have 3 or 4 parents call me every semester to ask me what is wrong with my teaching that their child can't pass this class. I had one parent come to class with their child to tell me that I had to pass his kid or else there would be no one to take over the family business. I've had parents call the president of the university because their child failed the class, and no one fails their child. It amazes me that parents come into my office on a regular basis to tell me their child isn't allowed to fail. Primary teacher here. First year in the job. From my classroom I can see out onto the street outside the school gates, and the same car is there every day with somebody sitting inside it. I told the headmaster and he said, "Don't worry, it's girls, mother." Every lesson now I wait a while and see this girl from my class running over to the car, speaking to her mother sitting inside for a minute or so, then running back over while she drives off until the next class finishes. Apparently the mother wants constant updates on what the lessons are about, whether she understands the work that day, and so forth. It's a shame because the girl is a real neurotic wreck, never laughs, always intently listening at what I'm saying despite the majority of it seeming too basic for her. Not a teacher. Typical. But I was in Rye in a freshman dorm and there was a girl who had grown up overly sheltered by her super Asian, super religious parents. She constantly made noise complaints even at 9 p.m. But the kicker was when there was a boy, Gasp, in her suite that had been invited over by one of her suitemates. The girl came downstairs to talk to me about how disturbed she was, and when I told her that she is an adult and she needed to handle talking to her suitemates herself, she promptly left, then came back with her mother on the phone demanding to speak to me. I endured half an hour of ranting and raving about how her precious baby shouldn't be subjected to these kinds of conditions and that she would have me fired. Mind you, this girl was 19 and should have been more than capable of handling things herself. The same girl also wore whatever her mother told her to wear over the phone. Cargo pants, loose unisex t-shirts, and a boonie hat does not do wonders for anyone. Mom, you're going to have to call administration. There is nothing I can do to resolve your issue. Click. I work at a university, and we always had orientation for students in the summer. They would come for a few days, meet with an advisor, sign up for classes, get a sense of the campus, even staying in the dorms with their roommates. 6 or 7 years ago, we noticed a disturbing trend. Parents were bringing along sleeping bags, and staying in the dorms with their kids. Suddenly a room that would be tight for 2 had 4-6 people sleeping in it. In the end, we caved. We now schedule events for the parents, just to keep them out of the students' hair, and even have separate dorm accommodations for them. Basically, we have a whole pretend orientation for parents, to give them something to do, while we try to get their kids set up for college. So that's why parents have their own orientation. A parent rang to complain that their precious was being discriminated against because they could not go on a school trip to a museum. It was on a first-come first-served basis. I repeatedly stated it was full and that it said on the letter limited places available. It ended with me saying there's nothing I could, or was willing to, do, and if they had a complaint, to pass it on to senior management. Boss supported the decision considering the kid didn't even take history and the parent contacted him ordering action. Drop someone from the list in order to accommodate their precious. They actually referred to their child as precious. Not a teacher, but I have a 36-year-old co-worker, let's call her Sheila, whose mother controls her finances. Sheila is constantly trying to bum money from people for a can of soda because she doesn't want to ask her mom for her money. Mom pays all of her bills and controls her checkbook. The problem is that Sheila continues to open up store credit cards to buy things. Her credit score is surely a minus 6 at this point. Does it count as parenting if it is a spouse? I have a cousin whose wife put a web filter on his computer so he can't browse inappropriate websites. He is 40. Went to dinner with my girlfriend and her two daughters the other day. She cut all of their food into bite-sized pieces. They are 13 and 14. Sorry, dude. Find a new girlfriend. I kinda like to play baseball and my dad became the president of our city's little league within a year and a half. Even at 10 I remember thinking, okay dad, time you backed the heck off. My neighbor's 11-year-old plays with infant toys and is spoon-fed literally still, while also playing Xbox and all of those Call of Duty-like games. His mom talks to him like a baby and keeps him home from school because she claims he's not ready, but it's because she can't let go. Doesn't help that they have a lot of money and buy him whatever he wants. It's a strange thing to see. That is illegal. First day I moved into college, a girl's parents gave her an 8-hour talk and spent the entire first night with her to make sure she would continue to be a good Christian girl. 17 hours later and she's sucking dong. When I was in my second year at university, a few new people joined the class. They had all either transferred from another uni, or had to retake the second year. Happens fairly often, so wasn't too strange to see some new faces in the class at the start of the year. Anyway, it's the first lesson for one of the modules and I'm sitting there doing some C++ stuff. A new student is sat next to me. I was quite happy to help people out when they were stuck. And so when he asked how some function worked, I showed him. Then the woman sitting on the other side of him gets out of her chair, walks over to my seat and demands to see my work in case I'm tell her son how to do things incorrectly. His mum had actually sat in the class for about 3 hours just waiting for someone to try and distract her son. Some people who shared other modules with him said she'd been in their lessons too, and just sat there waiting to pounce. The weirdest thing was that she then invited me to his McDonald's birthday party that he was having that day, so I could meet the rest of the family. I felt a bit like she was going to marry me to one of their other crazy relatives, so I made my excuses. Not sure that's helicopter parenting so much as CRZ parenting. Gagagaga. Yesterday I called the mother of one of my 7-year-old daughter's friends to invite her over to play at our house this weekend. The mom told me that not only could the little girl not spend the night with us, but she was not allowed to go anywhere without her 11-year-old sister. So, WTF am I supposed to do with an 11-year-old chaperone while the girls play? Is it usual to require second graders to be supervised by someone other than the host parent when they are invited to her friend's house? I had a 10th grader one year whose mom was the talk of the school. Apparently she was harassing teachers about his grades in the parking lot. She was a bit intimidating because she always came dressed in her police officer's uniform. But I never really had a problem because her son did fairly well in my class, and I have a very lenient makeup policy. I didn't really realize how overly involved in her son's life she was until one day in class his contact fell out of his eye. Luckily I had some solution for my own contacts in my purse. I offered to give him my solution, so he could put his contact back in. He couldn't do it. His mom had been putting his contacts in every morning and taking them out every night for 2 years. I was flabbergasted. God, my kid was friends with this girl and kinda. Parents were an older Jewish man and a very traditional Japanese lady. The parents slept in separate beds, still do. Mom slept in bed with daughter and showered with her. They wiped her butt, literally, well past 8 years old. They never left her side, as in would not let her play alone without them near. They didn't let her watch any movies and made her play piano for at least 8 hours a day. During a school carnival, the dad spotted some power cords that were not taped down, so he spent the entire night at the power cords warning every single child that walked by. They got involved with the school so that they could try to dictate curriculum. They took over the music program and hid the fat kids who they assumed were lazy and of lesser character in the back. Eventually they pulled daughter out of school and homeschooled her so she could spend more time on piano. Tried to get us to let our daughter go to school with them, in the garage. No, I have endless stories. Stories that go on for days about these guys. But I am late to the party. Worst part is the kid is of course miserable but at the moment thinks she is better than everyone. Because that is the line the parents gave her. My daughter has distanced herself and doesn't really like her. I see this a lot with older parents. Have your kids young read it. Not a classroom thing. But I always hated it when the Pinewood Derby became whose dad is the better engineer. It's a block of wood. You're supposed to paint it and put some wheels on it, not design a freaking rocket car and test in a wind tunnel. Not a teacher, but I do work at a university. There is a direct correlation between the amount of helicopter parenting that a person does, and the ineptitude of their children. I deal with an astonishing amount of parents who cripple their children socially by intervening on their behalf for the most petty ridiculous things, and it just makes me want to scream at them. They are literally loving their kids into a failed adulthood. Kudos to those students who step up and put an end to their helicopter parents' behavior. I live in a fraternity with other 9 people. We used to have a housemate whose mother would come every weekend to clean his room, buy him stuff, deliver frozen food so he wouldn't starve through the week. She stayed in a hotel nearby every freaking week. When he had a problem, instead of talking to us, he had his mother talk to us through Facebook. It was ridiculous. When we were close to kicking him out, his mother came all of a sudden, in the middle of the week, saying that he was not responsible enough to live by himself and she pulled him out of the house to live on a pensionator, which is basically a house usually full of freshmen with the housekeeper to take care of them. But man, we had some embarrassing moments with him. Not a teacher, but here is the worst case of helicopter parenting I have ever seen. So a buddy I used to be good friends with, had the most overprotective, helicopter style parenting of anyone I knew. He wasn't allowed to leave the house without them, cross the street, babied his entire life, all the way up through middle school and I believe even into his 9th grade. They refused to let him get his permit when he turned 15 and made him wait an additional year, and it really fricked him over emotionally. He wasn't allowed to play most video games, had to listen to their type of music. I mean the list just goes on and on. Anyway, I'm best friends with the kid at the time, from like 1st grade all the way until 10th when we had a falling out. But I am witnessing this strange overprotective parenting as he grows up. The father is a workaholic and makes very good money, high 6 figures, and the mom was this very athletic stay-at-home mom who, like I said, babied her children. He had a sister. Long story short, she comes out of the closet about a year after his 9th grade school year, has an affair with another woman and now they are living together. After the divorce they pretty much just stopped caring for the children altogether and did a complete 180. Mom drinks heavily and dad is always out of town on business trips. I mean, they literally went from full control to no parenting whatsoever. Daughter is a mess. She turned into a huge W and gained a lot of weight, and son is out of control now. He's not into drugs or anything like that. He's just reckless and has no common sense and no sense of direction. Yep. Fun crap. TLDR. Overprotective parents. Lesbian affair. Divorce. No parenting now. Kids are fricked. It would be a 180, not a 360. A 360 would end with them facing in the same direction. I knew a girl in my class who was kinda weird so everyone avoided her, and her mother was a huge helicopter mom. She was always making people invite her daughter to birthday parties and made everyone miserable. Once, she invited her daughter to me and my friend's small dinner party before the graduation dance. It was a super secret event, but this lady overheard some parents talking about the plans, and made sure her daughter got invited. A girl at my university moved into the dorm as a freshman, and when her parents left, her father had to drag her weeping mother down the hall to the elevator, not hold her as she walked, but actually physically pull her while she put up wailing resistance. It didn't come as a surprise later to find that student was unable to clean her room on her own and had pretty much no life skills whatsoever. A girl in my elementary school, which was private, involved uniforms, and held about 250 kids, max, had helicopter parents that were extra creepy because they were completely silent. They looked like they were brother and sister, and they would just loiter in the corner of the classroom during special events and birthday parties with eerie tranquil smiles on their faces. I had a swim party at the YMCA for my 9th birthday, and they were the only parents that stayed the entire time, smirking calmly, silent as the grave. Their kid was an angel of a student and by no means intentionally obnoxious, but she was a violent overachiever and teacher bootlicker. I would see them driving her to and from school with her strapped in the center backseat of their Volvo that had some kind of cage material separating the front and back seats. I heard a rumor that her parents had lost a child before they had her. If that was true, I can certainly understand why they were extra attentive, but the smotheriness was rather frightening at times. I worked at an Ivy League college. Best stories were not parents, but parents' personal assistants calling to try and do things the student should have been handling. Crazy. Not a teacher, just related helicopter parent story. My daughter went to a week-long horse camp as she does every summer. A new girl was in her class. Usually when a new student comes to camp, the counselors start them back at basics, just to ensure they know them. The girl's mother insisted she put into this, an advanced show jumping class, and how her girl was doing advanced dressage, show jumping and won all sorts of awards. Now there's simple basics you just need to know around horses. This girl didn't know anything about putting on bridle, saddle or grooming and had to have the counselors help her every time. Then she got stepped on several times and on the third day while crossing around the rear of her horse it kicked her in the chest. Last year I had a student who was born in Uganda. His mother, while well-intentioned, was absolutely smothering him. Each morning she walked him into the room, sat him, pulled out his homework and workbook and started his work. I had to creatively kick her out every morning. Once she left he was literally helpless. At 10 he still didn't know how to tie his shoes, unlock doors, sharpen a pencil, erase correctly, prompt himself to use the bathroom or speak to others without being fed the content. His mother did all of these things for him, to the point he would sit there and wait for someone to blow his nose when he sneezed. His homework was always correct, yet he couldn't recreate the content in class. He wet his pants several times because he relied on someone else prompting him to go. I worked at a private independent school, that is, Rich Kid Central, for a year before I started working in public schools. As bad as the helicoptering could get at the private school, it's a lot easier to deal with those kinds of parents than to deal with parents who go AWOL. I heard this as well. My friend is doing Teach for America in Memphis. She had 4 parents show up for parent-teacher conferences, out of 110 kids. It's heartbreaking. Not a teacher, but my dad coaches my younger brother, 11-12 YOs, in lacrosse. One of his teammates' mothers calls my dad to talk about practice and the schedule at least twice a week. She used to be a college track runner and still holds a few state records and now she is a personal trainer, so to say the least she is crazy about competition, winning etc. They went to a tournament a few hours away and stayed at a hotel and she called the room the kids were staying in and forced her son to order steak and pasta from room service every night and text her a picture to show how much he ate. And to be honest her son really is not that good. Not a teacher, but a good friend of mine in high school didn't go anywhere, aside from school, without her mom. She didn't have a dad around, so I understand they were very close. But even at after-school events, dances, sporting events, club meetings, mom was there. When she came over to my house to study after school, her mom would just walk around the block until we were finished. Sleepovers were not an option. When she went to college, her mom moved to the college town with her and, according to my friend's roommate, who I met a few years later, mom often slept on the floor of the dorm room. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. bye for now.